Hi, everyone. Now, I was going to talk to you about my plans to reanimate dinosaurs with TensorFlow, but I didn't want to steal those guys' thunder. So actually, I'm here to talk about open source collaboration in the TensorFlow project. And that's my job at Google, to work on growing the participation and the collaboration in the project in the whole community. So you guys all here and everybody watching on the live stream are a huge part of this already. If you saw a slide like this at the beginning of the day in Rajat's keynote, you'll have seen the numbers have already ticked up. In fact, in the 5 days I've been monitoring this slide, I've kept increasing the numbers because the amount of participation on TensorFlow is kind of staggering. As an open source project, it blows my mind when I came to work on it. And so much of that is due to the participation of everybody here in the community. There are parts of TensorFlow that wouldn't exist, and many of them, without that collaboration. For instance, whether it's Spark connectors, whether it's support for particular architectures and accelerators, or maybe certain language bindings. We not only benefit from a huge amount of adoption by being open source, but as the adoption grows, this is the way we sustain and grow the project. You saw this map earlier as well. This is just some of the GitHub stars that gave it their locations that we could map, and was far north as Norway and far south as the Antarctic. And what is really obvious right here now is, although there's a large team at Google developing TensorFlow, there are far many more people outside and far many more places who are using it. And the truth of a popular open source project is that more adoption is more demand. There's so much for us all to do together to grow TensorFlow. Now, you ever that thing where you turn up to a party and like, everyone's having a good time, and they all seem to know what they're doing and why it's such fun, but who am I going to talk to and what are they all looking at? And sometimes a large open source project can be a bit like that. You want to get involved in contributing to TensorFlow, but where do you start? You think this module or this feature over here is something you want to work on, but who do you find? Where do you find the right person to talk to? How do you learn, you know, what we're thinking about the direction for this? So we've heard some of those things from you, and we recognize that we want to improve our openness, our transparency, and our participation. We're trying to work on making it easier to get involved in TensorFlow. We've already, for instance, refreshed our roadmap, which you can find on the TensorFlow website, about the general direction of a lot of the code, and we'll do that a lot more regularly. But I want to talk about four initiatives that we have going that enable us all to work together more effectively and faster. The first of these is simple. It's a central community for everybody who's working and contributing to TensorFlow. GitHub has so much energy going on. There's so much great debate in all the issues, if you look in there, and the pull requests. Really thoughtful conversations and contributions. Thank you for your input in that, and thank you for being part of that. But what we don't have is a central place where we can collaborate. So what we'll be bringing online, in fact, you can go and subscribe now, is a mailing list, developers@tensorflow.org. And that's a place for contributors to TensorFlow to work together. So if you're contributing to TensorFlow or want to contribute towards TensorFlow, go and join. And we can work together as a community to discuss design ideas, to get feedback, to coordinate together. And many of the projects that you've heard about today have mailing lists that you can also find at tensorflow.org/community, whether it's TF Lite or tensorflow.js. So that's collaboration. Nobody talked about the fact that there are many use cases outside of Google that the core team just don't see. In fact, many more. Much more happens outside than inside the core team. So we want to make it possible for people with shared interests in a project to work together. This is where the beauty of open source comes in. How do we do that? So we're setting up a structure for groups to work on areas of TensorFlow together, special interest groups, or SIGs. We've been piloting the first of these for a few months now. This is called SIG Build, and it's all about building, packaging, and distributing TensorFlow. If you're familiar with TensorFlow, you know we build it in a certain way. Well, guess what? Not every architecture, not every application finds that the best way for them. For instance, Linux distributions want to build against the shared libraries in the distribution. That's not something we do. So we brought together a bunch of stakeholders over Linux distributions, companies like SUSE, Canonical, Red Hat, companies like IBM, NVIDIA, Intel, to collaborate in a group that will look at the build of TensorFlow and make that work more effectively for more people in the future. That's just one group, the pilot. And we want to pave the cow paths. So where there is energy and where there are people collaborating on a particular thing, that's a great candidate for bringing a special interest group together. This week, we're also bringing online a group for TensorBoard, where key stakeholders of the TensorBoard ecosystem can focus on design and collaboration, and also for the Rust language bindings, which is a completely community-driven part of TensorFlow. Each SIG is going to have a different personality, a different way of working, a different community. But the common thing is, we're going to provide forums where if you have a shared interest in TensorFlow in a particular area, we can focus on it. Now I'd like to talk about the design of TensorFlow. You know, one of the most amazing things and the benefits of TensorFlow is that the code that we release is the code that Google uses on a daily basis. It's kind of remarkable for an open source project. And so we're really careful about changes. We're really careful about design. We have a commitment, obviously, to the API through the 1.x series release. And we have design reviews internally. So when things change, we have proposals, we get feedback. But by now, you're thinking, well, you just said that so many use cases and so many users are outside of Google, yet you're having these design reviews inside. So what we're going to do is open up a public feedback phase to our design process so we can engage much more broadly with every contributor, every user, about how that might affect their needs and what their opinions are. Keep an eye on the developers at TensorFlow.org mailing list for this, because that's where we'll notify it coming online in the next couple months. And my hope that this is that this process will also be a way that everybody can communicate and discuss in a known process about the future direction of TensorFlow, whether you're in the core team here at Google or in the broader community. So contributing to TensorFlow isn't just about issues or PR requests. In fact, I would say I reckon that there's so much more, probably more energy going into people who are blogging, running meetups, doing presentations, teaching, doing courses in so many universities around the world. And we want to amp up and support the amount of content that educates and highlights TensorFlow. And so we're really excited already that so many of you do such amazing jobs, and we'd like to be able to point everybody in the TensorFlow community to the work that you're doing. So there's a couple of things that we launched to support this. The first, you've probably already heard, we now have a blog for TensorFlow, blog.tensorflow.org. One of the things that I'm most excited about with this blog is that as well as important announcements and education that we can put out, we're setting it up from the beginning to involve content from around the web and in the community. That's one reason we're using the Medium platform for this, to make it easy for us to integrate content from around the web and still give you the credit for the work you've done. So we'd really like to hear from you. If you have a blog post, an article you want to get into the TensorFlow publication, get in touch. Secondly, and if you're on the live stream watching us, you've kind of found out about this, we have a YouTube channel that's launched today. Now, one of the things I'm most excited about in this is a show called TensorFlow Meets. This is where we're able to get out into the world of contributors and users and really highlight some of the use cases, highlight the work of everybody. Again, this is a chance for you too. We'd love to meet you. We'd love to chat with you about what you're up to and have you featured on the YouTube channel. Again, reach out to us. We'd love you to be a part of it. There is one URL to get involved in all these things that I mentioned, tensorflow.org/community. So if anyone's mentioned a mailing list or a group or something to you about that today, please go to that URL and you find resources there. It is my hope that TensorFlow is going to continue to be a party, but maybe one you can find yourself part of a lot sooner and have more fun. Please feel free to reach out to me. There's my email address, ewj@google.com, and talk to me about anything to do with your experiences in collaborating around open source and TensorFlow. I'd love to hear about it. Thank you so much.